Alright guys, welcome back to the vlog. So today we're reviewing the 2019 Subaru Outback.
Knock knock.
Rod. So today we're reviewing the
2019 Outback.
Subaru Outback, which Bernie has on loan because his car got the infamous rod knock. So Frank Subaru is taking care of all the repairs, and they've loaned him this awesome Outback. So we want to take the opportunity to kind of like talk about it, review it. All right, Bernie. So I'm gonna let Bernie kind of take over because he's been driving this car for almost a week now.
Almost a week.
And he knows a lot more about it than I do.
Honestly, when they told me that they were gonna give me a rental car, of course in my mind was Impreza, Forester Sport. I wanted the Forester Sport. Or the Outback. I kind of was leaning towards the Outback. I didn't want an Impreza. I've driven the Impreza before, but the Outback was something that caught my eye. I just love the shape and the body style of the Outback so much. So when I got one, I was hyped. And it drives exactly how I imagined it would drive. It drives so smooth. It is a family car. It is just, it looks like a boat from the outside, but it handles very well. There's a little body roll, but that's expected on a really tall car. It's just extremely smooth. The power band is nice and smooth. It's an NA motor, so you're not getting that jerk of a turbo when you hit, 3,000 RPM. It's just super comfortable. And of course, a family car.
Yeah, and I've noticed too when we were driving up a hill, even with the AC on, it wasn't like struggling for power. Like in some of the older EJ motors, you know, I kind of felt that was kind of an issue, but here, not so much.
Yeah, so I really like this car because of how much technology is in it. So I come from a 2012 WRX, which, as you owners know, extremely boring dash, extremely limited technology, but this has sat nav, it has blind spot detection, eyesight, all the bells and whistles in here, and it is, all the driver aids are extremely helpful. Usually they're kind of, they get in the way, but this, since it's really meant for long drives with the family, like you would buy this more as a family car if you have your kids in the back, or a road trip car. And it has the lane assistance, so if you start drifting over into another lane, it'll automatically start steering the wheel back towards the center of your lane, kind of hands off, and it'll help you out.
So I'm gonna zoom in here on that orange light there. That's the lane assist, correct?
That's a blind spot.
Blind spot.
So if someone's coming up, it's not even if they're next to me, it's if someone's coming up at a faster pace than I am, Subaru, the Outback will sense it and tell me that there's someone coming up faster than I am. Because usually blind spot detection is when someone's in that area of your blind spot. This one actually detects like before they even get into my blind spot area. Like this F-150 was actually about a car length behind me still, and the light was already on. If that light's on and I start signaling, that light will start flashing at me telling me that is not a good idea.
As a passenger in this vehicle, there's a ton of room. Like in some of the other cars, I feel like even with the camera operating, like I have trouble finding angles just because there's very limited room, and in here I'm extremely comfortable. There's tons of leg space. Like I am just like living like a king here. The seats are extremely comfortable, and like Bernie was saying, this is a great family car. In the back, we've got tons of room. Great trunk space.
Trunk space is phenomenal. I love that trunk space.
Like I miss having a hatch, especially when I go surfing or like go on a snowboarding trip.
One thing that's kind of cool, but it's not for me. Of course, I love driving my manual car.
Yeah.
But this automatic does have the sport mode, so I can shift it over to the M for manual mode instead of the automatic. And now I have paddle shifters at my disposal, which is really nice, but they're not as quick as I'd like them to be. But of course, this is a family car. It's not meant to be driven super fast, but it automatically downshifts for me. But if I want to stay in first gear and rev it all the way up to 4,000, I can, but these paddle shifters are pretty nice. They're smooth. They're really smooth. They're not like a dual clutch system where it's just like bop, 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 but it is comfortable.
It is extremely, I don't even feel the shift. Exactly. To be honest.
And then, like I said, it automatically downshifts for you as you start braking. So you don't have to worry about like, oh, I have to rev match, I have to do anything. The computer will tell the transmission to shift down as I'm getting slower. So right now I'm in fourth, but as I'm slowing to this red light, it's gonna automatically go down to third, to second, and then to first.
That's super interesting. My mom's car does the same thing where it has the manual overdrive and it does shift down for you, but when you shift up, you can feel the shifts. That was extremely smooth.
Yeah. It's meant for day-to-day driving. Yeah, you're not trying
I agree.
Throw yourself into this.
Yeah, no, you're not trying to, like, you know, race Ferraris in this
exactly.
thing.
Exactly. Ferrari. This goes up to 7 gears, which is...
Seven?
I thought it was only up to 6 until it told me to shift up one more. But usually I'm used to 6 speed gearboxes, but this one has a 7 speed. So I'm not too sure about all of the trim or what the difference is between the premium and the limited, but it's just nice.
It is
luxury.
Nice.
Look at this
leather,
like,
the walnut.
I don't even know. It's just great.
I think
like,
I've
actual walnut veneer. It's not like some print.
Yeah.
It's actual wood. These seats are like three-way adjustable, so I can adjust the pitch of here, like where I can lift my thighs up this way. I can push my butt up towards the sky. I can adjust everything, especially the tilt in the seat. It's all electronic,
which is
so
amazing.
Nice.
And here in the passenger side as well, we've got all the same adjustments. Sometimes some car manufacturers will only give, you know, the cool stuff to the driver's side, but here you've got it on both sides. This car also features X mode, which is an off-road mode, if I'm not mistaken. What it pretty much does at lower speeds when you're off-road, it just makes it drive better in unpredictable road conditions, essentially. But I believe it only works at lower speeds.
This is how the car drives with X mode turned off. It starts out great. But now we see that the tires are starting to spin freely. Naturally, Subaru's AWD system is more than capable of handling roads like these. Yet if asked how smooth the car drove, the answer would probably be not very smooth at all. Let's try again, this time with X mode turned on. Once again, the car gets off to a great start. Here come those bumps again. The X mode operating status can be checked on this multi-function display. With X mode turned on, the tires stop spinning freely straight away, which makes driving up muddy, snowy slopes so much easier.
So we're gonna head over to Proctor Valley now, which is a dirt road. So we can take this a little bit off-roading, nothing too serious, just because this is a loaner car and
yeah.
It's being loaned to Bernie by our friends at Frank Subaru, who watch our vlogs.
Yes.
So shout out to Frank Subaru.
So
but,
super chill. Proctor Valley is a very flat dirt road, nothing too crazy. It's actually meant for people to drive on to get to their houses. Nothing like uneven terrain. So we just want to test it out.
And we were trying to type in, get it into the navigation. So one thing we do want to mention is Bernie was telling me that you can't actually type in the navigation while you're driving.
So right now, if I put it up, the keyboard will go. But if I start driving, it disables it. And then it will ask you to speak what you want to, what to type. So whenever I do though.
Say the house number, street, city, and state.
Let's say 2204 Fern Street.
I didn't get that. Let's try again. Say the house number, street, city, and state.
It's 2204 Fern Street.
I still didn't get that. Let's try again. Say the house number, street.
All right, so I guess it's gonna indefinitely keep doing this, which is a little bit annoying. Hopefully,
canceling.
Subaru comes up with a little firmware update that can kind of solve this issue, or maybe we're not doing it right.
Probably not doing it right. But
I mean, that's the only really negative thing that we've encountered here so far.
I just feel like I'm not doing it right. Maybe there's something I'm missing. But yeah, that's the only negative I feel about this car besides the engine. I would like a faster engine, but that's me. That's coming from a WRX.
Well, everybody always wants a faster engine, you know.
Other than that, there's no real negatives to this car. Other than the tiny bit of body roll when you're taking a corner, but
it's a lifted,
normal. It's a tall car. That's expected.
One thing I'm noticing here, I didn't even notice before, is that these control knobs have a digital gauge built into them. That's pretty baller.
And I really like that you can control your side and I can control my side. So I'm at low right now, and Victor's at 64. So I can.
But it's hot today, so I'm gonna put it back on low.
We're going back to low.
California, baby.
You know.
All right, we'll see you guys at Proctor Valley Road. All right, we're coming up here on the Proctor Valley Road, so it's gonna turn to like really dirt in a minute. Me and Bernie have both driven this road in the past. He's done it in his WRX and I've done it in my old Forester.
On stock suspension.
Same, and it's super bumpy.
Super bumpy.
We've mentioned before, I think, in the vlog that, you know, Bernie has some back problems.
Yeah, I've got sciatica with a slip disc in my spine.
I'm interested to see if there's any difference in the suspension in the Outback. I mean, it'll definitely be easier to clear these potholes because of the lift. Yeah, I'll just keep filming until we hit the dirt, which is, I think, right here. Look at the dirt. Sorry, guys. Sorry for the camera shake here.
There we go. It's actually not as bad as my WRX. My WRX, I could hear all the metal clanging in my WRX. This is actually not bad.
This is not bad at all.
The seats are taking a lot of
vibration.
Like,
for
I can
us.
Feel it in my feet, but then in my butt, I don't feel anything really.
I feel it in my butt, but it's not in my in my spine. Like, I don't feel it like in my lower back. I just feel like my butt fat jiggling a little bit. It's getting a little nasty. And then after here, I think it does smooth it up out a little further up.
Like, this is kind of manufactured bumps. You can see the consistency in the road. They're like,
they're your voice
in the road. Yeah. And I can feel the car kind of slipping around too.
I can feel it too.
It has its mind of its own right now.
Yeah, maybe we'll pull over in a minute and Google how to make this thing work. I feel it sliding a little.
Yeah, I feel it sliding a little bit. I don't see any traction control flashing though.
Yeah.
Stop right here. Let's see if we can put the X mode on. Okay, so I see a new symbol right next to the drive. It has a bumpy terrain. It has a super wavy.
I don't think I can see it with the camera.
It shows a little Subaru Outback, and underneath there's like a little waviness. And then it also says that it has a low range, low RPM symbol with a downhill, so it's telling me that it's limiting our throttle, I guess.
Okay.
Oh, even now, I'm not getting as much throttle response in the pedal. I'm pushing down a good bit, and we're not going so fast.
Okay, I'm interested to see if it'll automatically turn stuff off if we go too fast.
No, I'm not trying to go too fast.
No, I know, but yeah. I just wonder if there's a speed limit that you'll stay under.
Probably. I would say under 25. I like talking while we're doing this because it shakes my voice. Oh,
no.
It's getting intense. But immediate differences, I don't really feel it too much. It feels the same as before.
Okay.
But I do feel a lighter pedal. It's not letting me, it's not giving me as much juice as before. So it's kind of like the eco mode in normal cars where they like limit your throttle response.
Here's some big bumps. Those are some big potholes.
These ones you can feel.
The last set, barely felt them.
Okay, so it limited me when I got up to around 20, above 20 miles an hour. The speed limit thing turned off. So now it's just on the X Drive with the wavy, with the rough terrain symbol. I'm gonna give it a little more juice and see how it handles on here. Oh, it turned off completely. The X mode turned off completely now. So I got up to 30 miles an hour and it turned off. So I guess it does have a speed limit that it wants you to relax and do it at.
This feels great.
Yeah.
Super comfortable. Like, this is drivable. Like,
absolutely.
So you guys can kind of see what we're looking at here. It's beautiful out today. It was super overcast earlier, but it turned out to be a great day.
Right now we're doing about 30 miles an hour. It's not terrible.
So
now we're on an uphill. Let's see how it handles up there.
All right, uphill.
Like, the engine doesn't feel like it's struggling at all getting up this great. And this is actually a pretty good uphill. Like, in my WRX, I was pushing it pretty hard to get up this hill, trying to get traction and everything on some street tires. I like this drive.
Yeah, this is nice. Beautiful out here.
Oh, yeah.
That's what it's all about, a Sunday drive.
Mm-hmm.
In the Outback.
Right, we got air conditioning, we've got our nice seats in here. Just comfortable, man. Like, I don't feel the need to put both hands on the wheel. Like, that's how controlled the Outback feels. So closing thoughts for me is, I love the trunk space in the back. So it's super spacious back here. You've got the spare tire and all the tools right there. Super hidden, super sleek. But my favorite part are these levers here. So of course you have the regular trunk space, but if you don't have any passengers in the back seat, just a quick pull. So much space. It's so convenient. Coming from a WRX owner that has to pull it, push it down, make sure everyone's out of the way, all the headrests are all the way put down. This is just super convenient and I love it. All right, guys, so that's it for the 2019 Subaru Outback.